Here with Northwestern State Lady Demon head coach Jordan Dupuy. The Lady Demons won game this week, and we should point out it is a Thursday game because there's a little something going on here on campus Wednesday with LSU baseball coming in to play the Demons. Coach, you made the decision, or you agreed to move this game. Do you see a benefit in some ways? I mean, it's an extra day of rest or an extra day of preparation for a team that, especially on a week where you have just one game.
Yeah, I think it's a good thing, definitely. You know, especially after what happened Saturday from an injury standpoint. You know, looking at it today, and you and I just spoke on it, we were going to have eight people in practice today. So we're just going to have to sharpen some things up, get some shots up, things like that. So having that extra day of preparation is going to be big. It actually allowed us to not have to get the girls up early this morning to lift. We'll lift this afternoon and not have to worry about film until tomorrow. So it gives us an extra day to kind of rest a little bit, change up our schedule, hopefully get some legs back underneath us, and also to allow us the week in between games to get some recruiting done after we play on Thursday.
Well, you mentioned that time off, and in some ways that extra day may be a big thing. It may not be. We'll find out Thursday night exactly how it affected you. But I think the last couple of games you guys have gotten back to spreading out the scoring. And I know we've talked many times about what your system tends to feed the hot hand, and that's great. But it certainly helps to have multiple hot hands. And I believe it's three games in a row with three players or more in double figures. As a coach, that means something's going right and someone's listening.
It is. And even with that being said, and we spoke about it with the team after the game, there's still a lot of plays that went unfinished. And I think that's been the difference in a lot of when we come back in a game and then the lead gets spread back out. Happened against Lamar, happened against SFA, where we pulled the lead within five, had the ball, but we just didn't finish plays and the other team did. It could be off a turnover. It could be off a fast break. We missed some easy shots, things of that nature. But it is good to still spread out the scoring. But there's still a lot of scoring that's still left out there, too. And so that's something that we've got to get corrected. But it's a system that allows that to happen. Anybody can be the leading scorer. Anybody can be a scoring threat on every single possession. And then also it's a system that hopefully defense leads to offense and easy buckets. So when we're at our best, we're scoring on all three of those different aspects.
You've played pretty good defense in terms of turning people over all year. It looks like, and I think you mentioned it a little bit after Saturday's game, rebounding, you're doing a much better job of that. And I think seeing what Victoria Miller's done, 18 rebounds this past week against Lamar and Stephen F., maybe accepting a little bit more of a role and focusing on those things.
Yes, and we've changed it up. You know, we've always been a team that concentrates on defensive transition, but we've kind of flipped the philosophy on stopping people's fast break. What we've done is we've decided to crash four people now and only get one back. And by consistently crashing one, we've become a better rebounding team, especially on the offensive end. But two, it also slows people's breakdown. And so having that mentality on the offensive end also keeps that same mentality of going get the basketball on the defensive end, and Victoria's been a great example of that. Even if you don't actually secure the rebound, getting a tip out on the basketball, maybe give a guard a chance to you know, get the offensive rebound, the caramel, you know, off the glass is huge for us. Even if you get a tip and it goes out of bounds, it still allows us to set our defense up. So we've changed that mentality. There's some things that we're going to have to work on this week. From a post defensive standpoint, but what I told them in the locker room, we can't start focusing on post defense and forget the strides that we made on the rebounding aspect. So again, we're going to continue to do that, continue to push the rebound aspect, because again, it gives us extra possessions, but it also means that we're playing a lot more tougher and a lot more physical.
You played the number one and number two teams in the conference in terms of conference standing last week. You'll play a team that is half a game behind you in the conference standings Thursday in HBU. Your message obviously at this point doesn't change regardless of the opponent because you're more focused on yourself, but what have you seen from the Huskies, and I don't want to say you guard against overconfidence, but do you guard against overconfidence in a situation like
this?
Yeah,
I think we're going to have the same approach from a coaching standpoint, a scheme standpoint, a scouting report standpoint, whether it be Lamar SFA to Houston Baptist Incarnate Word. So if our demeanor doesn't change, the way we prepare doesn't change, I think the team keeps the same mentality as far as their preparation is concerned too. You know, this is a game that's a must win. Every game from here on out is a must win if we want to play in Katy. And so we're going to have to do some things to combat their size down low. They've got a good solid point guard that creates tempo for them. They do a good job playing good solid man-to-man defense. And they've been in a lot of close games this year, played some of our top teams in the conference very close. So it's going to be a tough game for us and one we've got to prepare the right way in order to come out on top.
And the good thing is you're back at home. You wrap up a three-game homestand. I know Saturday, what didn't go the way you wanted, but the crowd was there, and hopefully, I know that's something you harped on going into last week, but it's no longer packed Prather, but you'd love to see Prather packed on Thursday night.
No doubt. And one of the reasons we moved our game, because, again, the LSU game, baseball game Wednesday night, we want people here. The LSU game, hopefully it'll take place because that's a chance to market our game for Thursday night, let a lot of people know that we need them there. There's going to be probably 3,000 people at the baseball game, and if we can get half that crowd to come on Thursday, it's going to be a huge advantage for us. Our girls feed off of that. We want that. And in all honesty, our ladies deserve that. All the work that they've put in, they need to have people in the stands supporting them, no matter what the final score ends up being, because it's about showing appreciation for everything that they go through and the sacrifices they make in order to play out there on the court.
All right. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.